Good evening, children. Last class we have completed up to problem number 7, and today's class we are going to learn from problem number 8. Change the following fractions into decimals. So we have the question in the fractional format. We are going to convert it into a decimal format. Your first question: 47 divided by 20. In the denominator you have 20. You have to convert it into multiples of 10, 100, 1000 like that. So how to make 20 as 10, 100 or 1000? When you multiply a denominator 20 by 5, you will get 100. So whenever you multiply or divide, you will be doing it in both numerator and denominator. So 47 into 5 divided by 20 into 5. 47 into 5, if you multiply, you will be getting 235. 20 into 5 is your 100. Now, you have two zeros in the 100. So in the numerator, you will move two digits towards the left and you will place the decimal point 2.35 is your answer. So whatever multiplication you do, you have to do it in your rougher column. Third subdivision, 8, 1 by 40. It is a mixed fraction. So now how we are going to do? 8 into 40. 320 plus 1, 331. 331 divided by 40. Denominator, you have it as a 40. To make it as a 100 multiples of 10, 100,000, we are going to multiply 40 by 25. When you multiply 40 into 25, you will be getting 1000. Numerator also multiplying it by 25. If you multiply 321 into 25, you will be getting 8025. So denominator, how many zeros you have? 3 zeros. So you will be moving 3 digits, 1, 2, 3. So it is your 8.025. Problem number 5. 399 divided by 125. So you have to make the denominator 125 as multiples of 10, 100,000. So that I am using the number 8. When you multiply 125 by 8, you will be getting 1000. So numerator also multiplying it by 8. 399 multiplied by 8 is 3192. So now we got a fraction with denominator 1000. We are going to make it as a decimal number. So how many digits you have to move? 1, 2, 3 digits. So it is your 3.192. Problem number 7. 112 divided by 5. How to make 5 as a multiples of 10, 100,000? If you multiply 5 into 2, you will be getting 10. So it is an easy problem. Multiplying both numerator and denominator by 2. 112 multiplied by 2 is 224. 5 2s are 10. So in the denominator, you have 1 0. So you will be moving one digit towards the left. So it is your 22.4. Problem number 9. 113 by 40. I am going to keep this 100 as it is. And I am going to make this 13 by 40 alone with the denominator as multiples of 10, 100,000. If you multiply 40 into 25, it is your 1000. Similarly, multiplying numerator by 25, 13 into 25, it is 325. So, I will be keeping this 100 as it is. Because it is an integral part, the fractional part alone, we are going to make it as a decimal part. Three digits are there, so you will be moving three digits towards the left. So, we can place a decimal point at 100.325 is your answer. It's an easy problem. So, whatever problems I have completed in this 8th sum, you copy it in your classwork, leftover problems. You do it as a homework. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Our next chapter is addition subtraction of decimals. So, how will you add or subtract the decimal? When you add two or more decimal, write one below other with the decimal points in the same line. And as in case of whole numbers, placing the decimal point in the sum vertical below the decimal point. So, these are the steps we are going to follow. Exercise 7b. First problem, add the following. You are going to add whatever given in the question. You all know it already. You have learnt this, but for our 4.32, 0.62, and 7.18, we are going to write the number one below the other, keeping the decimal part at the right hand side and integral part in the left hand side. After writing the digits carefully, straightly on the 1/10th place, 100th place, writing the digits. Now we are going to start adding it. 8 plus 2 10, 10 plus 2 is 12, carry over 1. 6 plus 3 9, 9 plus 1 10, 10 plus 1 11, 1, carry over 1, keeping the decimal point straight. Adding 4 plus 7 plus 1 is your 12. So your answer is 12.12. Third subdivision. 15.46, 10.543, and 125.3. So writing the first number 15.46, then the second digit is 10.543. So 100th place you don't have any number in the previous digit, so you are including 0. The next number you have 125. So in the 100th place you don't have any number in the previous question, so you are including 0, 125.300. So wherever you don't have any number, instead of leaving it empty, you can use 0 so that it is easy for you in adding it. 3 plus 0 3, 6 plus 4 10, 0 carry over 1, 5 plus 4 9, 9 plus 1 10, 10 plus 3 13, carry over 1, 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 1 11, carry over 1, 1 plus 1 2 2 plus 2 4 4 plus 1 5, and 1 is there. So your answer is 151.303. The next question is 37, 7.42, 12.867, and 10. So you are going to write the digits carefully, one below the below, without changing the order. After decimal point, 1/10th digit will be there. If you don't have 100th digit, 1000th digit, you have to include 0. Here you have having 10 alone, you don't have any decimal part. You have only the integral part. So write 10 before the decimal point. After the decimal point, you don't have any digit, so you are using 0. Now let's add it. 0 plus 7, 7, 6 plus 2, 8, 7 plus 4 plus 8 is 19, carry over 1. 7 plus 3 10, 10 plus 3 13, carry over 1, 1 plus 2 3. So 33.987. So I have completed 3 subdivisions in the problem number 1. The remaining 3 subdivision is your homework. And problem number 2 and 3. So in problem number 2 and 3 you have subtraction. If you see the problem number 2, the first digit is bigger than the second digit, 40.51 minus 18.61. so first digit is bigger than the second digit, so you can subtract it and you can write positive symbol. Bigger number symbol is positive. If you look at the third sum, 15.42 minus 20.5, if you see the integral part, 15 is smaller, 20 is bigger, so 20.55 is the bigger number. So you have written the bigger number in the second place. We have the question like that. So what we are going to do, we'll make 20.55 minus 15.42 the normal subtraction. After subtracting it normally, you have to write answer in terms of negative, because the bigger number possesses negative symbol. So this is what we are going to follow now. So the second sub first subdivision, 40.45 minus 18.61, you are going to write integral part state, decimal part state. 1 minus 1 0, 5 minus 6 is not possible, so we are going to the integral part and borrowing 0. Can't borrow, so from 4 you are borrowing. 4 will become 3, 0 will become 9, from 10 you will borrow here. So 15 minus 6 is 9, 9 minus 8 is 1, 3 minus 1 is 2. So your answer is 21.90. Third subdivision, 150 minus 39.253. 150, you have an integral part. and you don't have any decimal part. So in the place of decimal part, you are using zero. How many zeros? Look at the second digit. You have three numbers in the decimal part. So you are going to include three zeros. So 150.000 minus 39.235. From 0 minus 5 is not possible. So directly we are borrowing from the integral part. From 5 you start to borrow. 5 will become 4, 0 will become 999, and the thousandth digit will become 10. 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 3 is 6, 9 minus 2 is 7, 9 minus 9 is 0, 14 minus 3 is 11. So 110.765. Third problem, 15.42 minus 20.5. If you see the question, the bigger number is in the second place. So what we are going to do, normal subtraction we are going to follow. We are going to write the bigger number first and we are going to subtract from the bigger number, the smaller number we are going to subtract. So 20.55 minus 15.42. Normal subtraction we are going to follow. 5 minus 2 is 3, 5 minus 4 is 1, 0 minus 5 not possible. So from 2 we are borrowing. So it will become, 0 will become 10, 10 minus 5 is 5, 1 minus 1 is 0, 5.13. Normal subtraction if you do, it is 5.13. But your question carries a negative symbol where the number is bigger. So in the answer, you are going to include a negative symbol, minus 5.13. The same model you are going to follow for the next two subdivisions, 0.1 minus 0.54, 0. Your integral part is same. Look at the decimal part, 1, 5. 5 is bigger, so 0.54 is bigger. So what you will do, 0.54 minus 0.1, you will subtract. After subtracting, in the answer, you will be using negative symbol. So it is an easy problem. Problem number 1, 2, 3, leftover problems, you do it as a homework. Whatever sums I did in this video, you copy it in your classwork. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. After watching the video, send the message in the group that you have saw the video, Max video. And your homeworks problem, whatever you solved, send it to my personal number. I'll be checking it out and sending the feedbacks to you. Thank you, students.